As downtown Cleveland slowly returns to a sense of normalcy after All-Star Week, well, the city is taking a bit of a victory lap.
Oh, and we're loving it. We're enjoying the reviews of a well-carried-out five-day event. In this News 5 original, John Kosick looks at what it means going forward.
City of Cleveland, Ohio has rolled out the red carpet literally and figuratively.
The red carpet is now gone, rolled up and trucked away, but the good vibes continue.
The feedback we're getting is just off the charts.
That's good because in town were those looking at Cleveland for future events and those with big events already planned.
Actually, NFL brought another half a dozen of their event people here, spent a lot of time in town. It's great they actually talked a lot with the MLB people.
Yes, the NFL draft is just under 2 years out in the NBA All-Star game, less than a year after that.
I think it helps. I think you're just, you know, you're continually geared up. You keep a lot of those same systems in place, a lot of those same relationships in place, and you keep that energy going.
The key Gilbert knows is to not be complacent. While Philadelphia, for example, put its best foot forward for the visit of the Pope in 2015, there was a noticeable letdown in spots the next year when they hosted the DNC.
You know, it's funny. We actually sent a note to our staff with that exact message of not being complacent. That one event is done, and the next event we have, they have to feel in their own space every bit as special and well taken care of as Major League Baseball did. If we don't continue to do that, we're going to start to fail.
It was 5 years ago this week that Cleveland learned they would be hosting the Republican National Convention. Successfully pulling it off in 2016 sent a message that this week's All-Star game drove home.
I think it's put us on a level with the top cities in the country at the ability to not just host, but successfully host anything that's thrown at us.
In Cleveland, John Kasich, News 5.